Hi guys, welcome back to the show. Everybody good? I thought I'd bring something new to the channel. I have no idea what I'm playing. My mate said I should get this. He said I might like it. This is a very old PlayStation 4 game. This is Stick It to the Man. It's meant to have an interesting story. Apparently my mate said it's basically me. So I'm curious. So we'll have a little look, shall we?
Space. Final frontier. That's what it's called, right? It's beautiful. Endless. Feel the warmth of the sun millions of kilometers away on my skin without any atmosphere to stand between us. The upside is it's a truly amazing feeling. The downside is I'm truly about to die. Who would have guessed I'd die floating alone in space? I mean, until now, I'd never been any higher up than the top floor of my apartment building, and I only went up there once. My mistake. It all started yesterday. Ordinary day like any other. It's until I got hit on the head. Ouch! Jeez! That was a 3-star impact, Wally. This one needs some work.
3 stars? You sure, Ray? R&D insists that this one be a 1-star hothead. 1.5 tops. That's some quality hothats you're testing.
You want to trade spots and see for yourself? 3 stars. Didn't notice any birds flying around my head, though. That's something.
All right, this one's next. It's a new material R&D wants to try. It says here it's based mostly on recycled banana peels and used juice boxes. Big bite of bell, huh?
Oh, see you tomorrow, buddy.
Ray, I hate to be the one to tell you this, but you actually live all the way to the left. Weird, huh?
Experience required. It seemed like such a good idea at the time.
This is Gamma 3. We've encountered storm systems too large to go around without delaying landing time. Please advise.
Gamma 3? Son, you told me your name was Jimmy.
Honestly, I kind of like this. This is kind of weird. I like the layout. I like the way they've done everything out of cardboard and everything's 2D in a 3D world. That's kind of sick. Can I talk to any of these? No? Squares, Matt. All I can do is jump. Okay.
Jumping is required to get to and from work.
I like the humor to it. I like it, you know?
Gamma 3 calling base. Please respond. Base, storm now intensifying beyond safety thresholds. Unusually intense lightning activity observed. Attempting to abort. Emergency support requested.
Wow! Plane made out of paper can't take the heat, huh? Or even a little rain? I bet those eggheads who thought up a paper airplane was a great idea, because it wouldn't be detected by enemy radar. I'm feeling pretty smart right now. Tell me you didn't get him to redesign our parachutes, too.
Dude, this is actually kind of cool. I really like this. But the storyline gets pretty good.
Lightning now now level 5 alert. The Omega level package is in danger. Repeat, the Omega level
package. Son, I appreciate your concern, but my package isn't.
That thing.
What the? Oh, where am I? What's this spaghetti arm doing sticking out of my head?
Okay, stay calm, Ray. Last thing I remember was leaving work and jumping a lot. And then, getting it on the head. Of course! The hand growing out of my head, and this whole crazy world is all a dream.
Huh. Wow, okay. Can I do anything with this hand? Oh, I can move it around.
Me.
Use LS to aim and press R1. Oh. Okay.
High five me, Ray.
I give the best high fives, Ray.
High five me instead.
Ray, you may think you know high fives, but you haven't experienced a high five until you've high fived me.
Please, please, crazy pin creatures, one at a time.
Swim pins,
high
crap.
High five all of you, I promise. Whoa, this arm is awesome. Yeah. Oh, I'm almost sorry. I'll have to wake up from this.
I think I'm going this way. SpongeBob music as well, it's kind of cool.
Hey, cool! A giant robot! Wait, these colossal fingers look familiar. Oh, wow! No way! Giant me robot!
A giant me robot. This is random. What okay. The hell?
So my head is flooded with elephant juice. And inside are a bunch of gears that aren't moving.
What is going on?
Which probably means I'm knocked out, and I need to drain the water from my brain. Got it.
Help! Help! I can't hold my breath forever.
Oh, and there's a creature swimming around in my head. Not sure what to make of that one, honestly. Can you hear me, little guy?
Help! Help!
We gotta help him.
I can't hold.
Pink elephant pouring water through a hole in my head. I didn't bring my dream symbolism app with me, but I'm guessing this means I'm a confident, handsome man that ever. Hey, a sticker of a tap. Well, it was worth a shot. That doesn't work. Wrong sticker.
Okay, now what do I do? Now I'm holding a cork. We put the cork. No!
I saved you, crazy alien creature thing.
Finally dry at last! But the controls don't work! I need power! If only there was a way to get that heart working again.
What heart? Got no idea what they're talking about. Where do I go down here? You actually got to pull it, okay.
Yoo-hoo, heart! Come here, heart. Heart, come here, girl. I miss you.
Weird. My girlfriend lives in Robot Me's heart. And she's calling for a dog named Heart. Dreams are crazy. Oh well, at least I'm not back in high school and also naked in this one. Again.
Can't do anything with that, can I? Nope.
Oh,
are you?
Hey there, little guy. You're Heart, Arlene's dream dog, aren't you? How's it going, Heart? Oh, there's a good girl.
Come with me. Okay, how do I pick him up then? I can't. Okay. Pin lets me get back, okay.
Ahoy, matey! Greetings! Ahoy. I be Redbeard the Scary. I'll have you know that back in my day, I was the most feared pirate on all the seven seas.
Bad news, buddy. You're just a figment of my imagination. And this is all a dream.
You? Aye. It occurs to me that in real life, skeletons don't talk. Will you do an old sea dog a favor and dream me back to life again?
Well, I kind of need to lead this dog back to my girlfriend. You've got an arm made of bone, so...
I hear you, landlubber. Well, I'd be happy to lend a hand. Oh, oh, he just realized how well lend a hand worked back there. That wasn't even on purpose.
Honestly, I kind of like this. My mate was right. This is actually not too bad. Hey, yeah.
Heart, come.
Good girl. Shit. Oh, right. It's alright. And pal.
Heart, you came back. What a good girl. Who's a good girl?
This game is so weird, but I like it.
The best girl. Yes, you are. I'm so happy. I love you, Heart.
I always knew Arlene was the woman of my dreams. But it's nice to have it confirmed.
All the pieces are in place. I was just about to leave, but now I think I'll stay after all. Yes, I'll be able to stay here indefinitely. As long as the host survives.
Wait, what?
Mind over matter. So this guy's clearly lost his mind.
Incident.
An incident?
A crash, sir. And the subject is... missing.
Why are you coming to me for instructions? Obviously, I'm going to tell you to find it. It's the most powerful weapon in the universe.
Spaghetti! Spaghetti in my head!
You think? Wow! What a crazy dream! Oh, good thing dreams are stupid and don't mean anything!
You're awake! Perfect. That'll be a lot easier than carrying you out.
Huh? What will be easier than carrying me out?
This. Get out!
What?
Your insurance doesn't cover head injuries, mister. Get out!
Head injury? What? What happened to my head? Hey, quit shoving! Will you just tell me what happened to my head? Hey, easy on the buns! Bandages, all kinds of itchy.
I should just tell it to him straight.
Oh, this can't be happening.
Ouch! Careful,
I will bet you. I will do it.
So shiny.
Become a chef, they said.
Holy crap. What the hell? Okay. I'm hallucinating. Arms don't grow out of heads. I just gotta get home and sleep this off. It's all a hallucination, that's all. It's just a hallucination that lets me read minds accurately.
You can walk slow or fast. It's kind of nice on the analog stick. So I'm guessing the alien's in our head, and this is the alien reaching out to the outside world and helping us. Maybe. It sounds like this guy has lost his mind. So, I'm guessing that's what's happened. So yeah, I think we can actually read minds now.
Listen, do me a favor. I kinda didn't think this through.
Obviously.
And I left the handbrake on in the car. Could you disengage it for me?
Actually, maybe you can do me a favor instead. I'm looking for a cab ride home, and...
I got my own problems here. Problems I do not want to talk about. Listen, thanks for nothing. I'm just gonna wait here till somebody else comes and disengages my car. Peace!
Maybe... Maybe I can use my hallucination brain arm to read his mind and find out what his problem is.
Barbara, if only you had left me for that mafia don with the mad nutty smile. If only my own smile had that sparkle that drives you wild. If only I could take back years of poor dental hygiene. If only I could have you back.
Right. Is that all I can do with him then? Is... Yeah, I don't need it again. Ugh, watch the car.
I gotta find a way to help this dude get his lady friend back.
Boogie Palace.
Keep it up, Barbara. We'll win this competition for sure. Especially since my biggest challenger had an unfortunate accident.
What? Huh? What was that? Sorry, I was kind of lost in your teeth there. I just love your smile, Don.
Don's my position, not my you know what? Don's fine.
Honey, I don't care what you're called, as long as you keep showing me those sparkly teeth. An adult human, and my major criteria in selecting a mate is how shiny their teeth are. I may have made some bad decisions somewhere. However, on the other hand, Ooh, shiny teeth.
Okay, Barbara's weird. What is this guy doing?
Some might say that murdering a man to win a dance competition is sociopathic. But is it really sociopathic to only see people as obstacles to be overcome by any means possible? Wait, maybe it is. Maybe that's actually the textbook symptom of sociopathy. Oh well, too late now.
Ed, where are you? We've been practicing for weeks, and you promised you wouldn't stand me up. Don't do this to me, Eddie.
Nobody to tuck him in at night. Nobody to give him his belly rubs and his teeth scratches. But he's such a gentle soul. He needs me to... He needs me to take care of him.
Chicken. Chicken! I'm nature's greatest predator, buddy. And I'm tired of chicken. I got a taste for special treats, and I ain't coming out for anything except human limbs, baby. Delicious human limbs. So long and crunchy. So full of valuable vitamins and minerals.
It's my good friend Bitey comes and eats it first. Bitey, here, buddy. I've got your favorite treat, chicken. Delicious, raw, dead chicken. Come get it, buddy. Mmm, I can't wait to eat all this chicken myself. Unless my good friend Bitey comes and eats it first.
Forever! Forever! Oh, I can't believe our relationship is over! I hate to see him hurt, but it had to be done, right? It had to be done! Breakups suck, but I still care for him. I just wish everything didn't have to be so sucky.
What a kind and noble heart here breaks.
This food is almost ready, but it needs one more spice. But what? Something that tastes of despair. Something that is condensed, liquefied sorrow. Where can I find this ingredient?
Ah.
gosh, Rachel's gonna kill me if I don't make it to the disco competition on time. Only she won't, because I'll already be dead. Because these guys are gonna kill me real soon. This is it, Ed. You're going to be dead soon, and you never went skydiving. You never ate caviar, and you never beat the Silver Surfer game for the NES. You're gonna die with regrets, Edo. Oh, if only I'd spent more time learning how to escape from Trunks instead of learning the enemy attack patterns in the Silver Surfer for the NES. Although, honestly, I'm glad I spent so much time playing Silver Surfer for the NES. The game was tight. Oh, gosh. Oh, God.
As soon as little Mario could walk, he'd be over every day to say hi to Beatrice. And he was always so excited to see him. He'd bark and bark and bark. Just endless, frantic barking from Beatrice. Yes, sir.
Oh, gosh.
Afraid I don't have any sweet.
I never forget a smell. Those are the drips that tortured me every day when I was a puppy. They tied firecrackers to my tail. Gosh darn it. I'd eat them alive if only I had my teeth. I need teeth, darn it.
Forever.
Like, sure. You it's good to be the big brother. Hey, what's the big idea? Get any closer. Hey, what's the big idea? Get any. Hey, what's the big idea? Get any closer and I'll get my brother to beat you up.
Typical. I have to do the hard labor while my big brother stands around and smokes. Hooray! You got born 10 seconds earlier. That definitely means you have to never work a day in your life. Oh, yes, absolutely. I deserve to be the guy mixing the concrete. Heck, if I didn't want to do that, I would have pushed my way to the front line 30 years ago, right?
Hey, what's the big idea? Get any closer and I'll get my brother to beat you up, understand?
Stick.
Oh, nightmare.
Well, it was worth a shot.
I'm afraid I don't have any.
Well, it was worth a shot. That doesn't work.
L'ingredient parfait! This meal, it is... perfection! Perfection! You can really taste the sorrow.
For a bit. Laura and the kids will be ecstatic to see you again. They may show it by screaming at us and running away, but that's just their way.
Oh, a hole.
I'm not sure this fits.
What the fuck am I meant to do with the teeth? Ah, these teeth belong to the little doggy. Or they go to the one with the teeth.
Beatrice? Is that Beatrice? Where did you get those teeth? Good doggy. Good doggy.
Carry me, Luigi. Carry me at that run faster, Luigi.
Nice. And it's not too late for the competition. How can I ever say thanks?
Well, I could use a drive.
I've got it. I'll dance for you, and then we can talk about Silver Surfer.
For the NES?
Aw, man, I really want to talk about this, but I'm late.
Ed, you made it! Where were you?
Locked in a trunk, but this stranger wandered in and helped me out.
It's been a good day for that, I think. Let's dance.
An amazing set! First place goes to Rachel and Ed for their routine, Rachel's Education in Dance.
This is an outrage. I paid good money to ensure my victory. I'm so angry, I could swallow my teeth. I could literally swallow my teeth.
I'll save you, Don. I'll save you, Don's teeth.
Right, so we got teeth now.
Don's actually kind of gross and really old. And I've got nothing in common with him. He's lost that sparkle somehow.
Hey, buddy.
Don's actually
kind of gross and really old.
Sparkle somehow. Don,
it's time to shake my bod and chew gum. And actually, I'd much prefer to shake my bod than chew gum, so this is working out well.
Ed, buddy, it's been a long, strange day. But you're ending it in a crazy dance scene, so I think things worked out pretty okay.
I'm out.
Can't stop this dance train.
Don?
My mouth feels lighter. Like there's fewer teeth in it somehow.
So what the hell? Where did the shiny teeth go? Oh yeah, he's got bad hygiene.
Barbara,
no, wrong button, sorry. Whack.
His teeth are so sparkly. They feel good! They feel right! What am I doing here? I need to go show Barbara!
You do what?
Barbara! I'm back! And I got a mouthful to say to you!
Bernie? Is that you? You're so sparkly. Oh, Bernie, where did we go wrong?
We didn't, Barbara. Just forget it. Everything up to now is non-canon. Canonicity starts right now.
Hey, thanks for the ride home, Bernie.
Thanks for reminding me what's really important. Love.
Sparkly teeth.
Finally, I'm just a few jumps away from home, where I can put all these hallucinatory spaghetti arms and oddly accurate mind reading behind me. Aline, I'm home. I've had the craziest day, honey. Check it out. Think of a number between negative gazillion and infinity plus 3. Bet you $50 I can read your mind. Eileen, I know that the arm sticking out of my head looks weird.
The what?
The arm sticking out of my head. I know it looks weird, but...
There's no arm sticking out of your head. Ray, are you going nuts on me? Are you dropping insanity balls on the floor?
She can't see it.
I don't think so. You really can't see it?
Sweetie, why don't you go see my shrink? Dr. Egglesworth helped me a lot. I'm not afraid of grapes anymore, see?
Jeez. Maybe I am crazy. I guess it wouldn't hurt to see Dr. Egglesworth. I believe his office is over here, to the right.
Right, folks. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you guys liked it as much as I did. Honestly, it's a fun little game to play. I kind of like it. I honestly kind of like it. I like the arm coming out of his head that no one else can see. He's actually slowly losing his mind. It's kind of cool. I like it. I like the animation to it. The camera angles are nice as well. The 3D world that's 2D. It's kind of cool. Right, folks. I hope you enjoy. I'll see you later. I'll see you in the next one. Toodle-pip.